Good evening and welcome parents to the St. Roch Catholic Secondary School Regional Arts presentation for 2021. We're excited that you're here. My name is Mark McCallen. I am the Regional Arts Coordinator.
Hi, I'm Jamie Marr and I am the Arts Department Head. And we're very excited to talk about the Regional Arts Program here at St. Roch.
Are you ready for high school? Cause I don't give myself often, but I guess I'll try today. Cause I've been my heart broken before, and I promised I would never let me hurt anymore. But I tore down my walls and opened my doors and made room for one. So baby, I'm yours. Oh baby, I'm yours.
Being an arts major is not just about taking certain classes. It's not just about developing and expanding your skills.
It's not just about the group of people you're with.
Or the performances you do.
It's not just about the gear you use.
It's not just about the endless opportunities you have.
Or the places it'll take you.
It's not about you, and it's not about me.
It's about everything.
Every little detail.
Every laugh you'll have with your new lifetime friends.
And every world-class skill you'll learn.
It's about going above and beyond.
Pushing through challenges.
Overcoming every obstacle.
Every time you step on that stage,
pick up that instrument,
and sing your first line.
You are a regional arts major.
You are a regional arts major.
You are a regional arts major.
You're a regional arts major.
You are regional arts major.
We'd like to begin this evening with a prayer in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Lord, we ask you through the intercession of St. Roch, our friend, that we may live according to your will and that we may be reconciled in your love. Help us to love one another and to serve the unfortunate and the poor of our time. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ. St. Roch, pray for us. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Titled our regional arts presentation, Pathway to Success. We feel here at St. Roch that through the arts, that your son or daughter will ultimately be successful in whatever step, whatever journey they're on, post-secondary or otherwise.
The Pathway to Success is a model that shows us that working together, we can get ready for the workplace, we can get ready for college, we can get ready for university, and it shows steps to become a stronger learner and a more successful student.
The agenda for tonight is as follows. Here we are, Mr. Marr and myself speaking to you in the general presentation. And that should last till about 6:45. Following that, there will be breakout sessions. We'll give you about 15 minutes to grab a coffee or a tea or a snack. And then at 7 o'clock, the breakout sessions for the area that your son or daughter is interested in. The links to each area, the Zoom links, can be found on the St. Roch website under Regional Arts. Later on in the presentation, Mr. Marr will guide you through our website so you know exactly where to find these links. Those Zoom breakout sessions are a perfect opportunity for you to ask those specific questions to the area that you're applying to. Information will be presented on the curriculum, on all the different extracurricular opportunities in the program and the audition process itself. And now we have a message from our principal, Mr. Jeff Quenville.
Hello, I'm Jeff Quenville. I'm the principal here at St. Roch, and I want to thank all of you for your interest in our exciting regional arts program. With all the shutdowns that COVID caused, it was an effect on us, but this year we've been able to return to having live performances and doing all the things we love to do when we think of the arts. So, I wish you all the best and wish you well in your audition process. And at that, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Marr and Mr. McCallen to give you more information.
We offer five areas that your son or daughter can apply to: dance, drama, instrumental music, media and communication arts, and vocal music. Your son or daughter may apply only apply to one area though. So they have to really, really think and do their own research to figure out which area they would like to spend the next 4 years. Mr. Marr, do you have anything to add there?
I don't think I have a whole lot to add right there, but going on to the next thing that we're looking at is the timetable. And the timetable is always a little bit confusing at first, because we're looking at the entire journey from grade 9 through to grade 12. Not just 1 year at a time, but kind of planning the whole thing. And as we're looking at grade 9, each year, grade 9, 10, 11, and 12 will always have something in their main course of study, whether that's dance, drama, instrumental, media, or vocal. And then in grade 9, they will also have their religion course together with other arts majors, so that it gives them something relevant to their learning. The conversations are a lot deeper because we're having conversation with family. Moving on to grade 10, once they've studied their base arts choice, each area has their own kind of extension course in grade 10 and in grade 11, and then again in grade 12. Mr. McCallen, did you want to talk about the new optional course in grade 11?
Yeah, so over the years, grade 8 students, our students speak to us. They communicate to us about the successes and challenges of being in a regional arts program. And one of them was the fact that there are three courses in grade 11. This is a brand new option starting in 2022. Over the years, our students have spoken to us and we have listened that grade 11 can be a challenging time where students are starting to focus their courses towards their career path. And by having three arts courses for some students just proved too challenging. So we now make that third arts course optional. Students can do all three, or they can choose two, and that leaves them with three electives to choose from. And then in grade 12, they have two arts courses. Mr. Marr, do you have anything to add about the schedule for the 4 years?
Yeah. Where there's two arts courses, there will always be one in first semester and one in second semester. And part of that is to kind of balance out everybody's schedule, but it also creates that one sense of I have that family connection at least once during my day throughout high school. And so it really does build a stronger, better community through this timetable.
I also like to point out that the courses that are not highlighted are mandatory courses that every student in a Catholic high school completes. So those are mandatory courses. If you were not in a regional arts course program, let's say, for example, in grade 10, well, then you would have two electives, two courses that you want to do that you enjoy. Well, if you're in the arts program, those are chosen already for you. We now have a message from our guidance department. The head of our guidance program is Ms. Sandra Tomalilo, and I'm going to read out her message to you. And we think this is very, very important information. First off, although St. Roch is a regional school of the arts, we are a regular high school and offer courses just like any other high school. All these courses, including the ones a student takes as part of the regional arts program, go towards the completion of an Ontario secondary school diploma. In addition to the secondary school diploma, regional arts students also receive a regional arts certificate upon graduating. Secondly, it is a good idea to follow through with all registration deadlines set up by your home high school. Once your child is accepted, we'll provide next steps to ensure the transfer of information is made easy. So this is very, very important that you meet your mainstream registration deadlines. This year's deadline is Monday, December 13th. In the event that you are not accepted into St. Roch, it is very important that you're registered at your feeder high school. If you are in deed accepted into St. Roch and you register, we actually have a night where you actually register, then the guidance department takes care of all your information getting moved here to St. Roch. So there's no worry from your end. When choosing courses for grade 9, please look at your child's achievement in each subject before deciding whether a course should be academic, applied, or locally developed. And as you move closer, if you are accepted, our guidance department is always available to answer any further questions. So the question you may be asking is, why a regional arts program? And I'm going to pass it off to the expert, Mr. Marr. He actually was here at the very beginning of the arts program. He actually created the program. And so he knows more than anybody. And so we'll pass it off to him. Mr. Marr?
I know more than anybody, as I frequently want to tell everybody that will listen. a lot of people say, why have a regional arts program? And one thing that I noticed after I became a teacher, looking back at my own education, was the inconsistencies in my grades. And what I noticed was whenever I had an arts-based subject in my schedule, everything else in my life went better. The marks were higher. I was happier. I was stronger. I was healthier. And so there are a lot of students out there that need this kind of program because it helps us communicate with the world. And I just want to play one of my favorite videos from a speaker named Sir Ken Robinson, who is an educational guru throughout England, as he discovers a student that was having trouble succeeding in a regular program. And what changes an arts program made to her success?
I'm doing a new book at the moment called Epiphany, which is based on a series of interviews with people about how they discovered their talent. I'm fascinated by how people got to be there. It's really prompted by a conversation I had with a wonderful woman who most people have never heard of. She's called Gillian Lynn. Have you heard of her? Some have. She's a choreographer, and everybody knows her work. She did Cats and Phantom of the Opera. She's wonderful. I used to be on the board of the Royal Ballet in England, as you can see. And anyway, Jill and I had lunch one day. I said, how'd you get to be a dancer? And she said, it was interesting. When she was at school, she was really hopeless. And the school in the 30s wrote to her parents, said, we think Jillian has a learning disorder. She couldn't concentrate. She was fidgeting. I think now they'd say she had ADHD. Wouldn't you? But this was the 1930s, and ADHD hadn't been invented, you know, at this point. So it wasn't an available condition. You know, people weren't aware they could have that. Anyway, she went to see this specialist. So this oak paneled room, and she was there with her mother, and she was led and sat on this chair at the end, and she sat on her hands for 20 minutes while this man talked to her mother about all the problems Gillian was having at school. And at the end of it, because she was disturbing people, her homework was always late and so on, little kid of eight, in the end, the doctor went and sat next to Gillian and said, Gillian, I've listened to all these things that your mother's told me. I need to speak to her privately. So she said, he said, wait here, we'll be back. We won't be very long. And they went and left her. But as they went out the room, he turned on the radio that was sitting on his desk. And when they got out the room, he said to her mother, just stand and watch her. And the minute they left the room, she said she was on her feet, moving to the music. And they watched for a few minutes, and he turned to her mother, and he said, you know, Mrs. Lynn, Gillian isn't sick. She's a dancer. Take her to a dance school. I said, what happened? I said, she did. I can't tell you, sir, how wonderful it was. We walked in this room, and it was full of people like me. People who couldn't sit still. People who had to move to think. Who had to move to think. They did ballet, they did tap, they did jazz, they did modern, they did contemporary. She was eventually auditioned for the Royal Ballet School. She became a soloist. She had a wonderful career at the Royal Ballet. She eventually graduated from the Royal Ballet School, found her own company, the Gillian Dance Company, met Andrew Lloyd Webber. She's been responsible for some of the most successful musical theatre productions in history. She's given pleasure to millions, and she's a multimillionaire. Somebody else might have put her on medication and told her to calm down.
Now, such great words from Sir Ken, and I just love hearing that message every year. There's another quote, and this one this time from Benjamin Franklin. Tell me, and I forget. Teach me, and I may remember. but involve me and I learn. And that's what our regional arts program is all about, getting students involved so that the telling and the teaching start to become concrete in their memory, concrete in their own learning style. It's all about going further in doing.
And Mr. Marr, to that point, I think it's so important that because our students are doing, you know, there is the theoretical part in all the different areas, but it's through the doing. And I mean, this place is a hustle and bustle. Lots going on here. And as you mentioned in your Why Regional Arts segment, that our students are exceedingly happy when they're doing.
Mm-hmm. And there's just so many activities going on. And now that we're coming back into life being a little bit more normal, it's nice to see all the performances going on. We've got rock TV happening again. We've got dance shows. We have plays. The drum line is doing Santa Claus Parade. The vocal program was out singing for the memorial for Bill Davis. And so just great opportunities to perform again. One thing that we always want to look at are, what are some of the advantages? What can an arts program do for me? And one thing that we notice is improved academic performance. When the brain is engaged on more than one level, students respond in other aspects of their life. And so we end up with improved academic performance. Confidence. We see students unsure of themselves, and so many people lack that initial confidence. And through performance and through community, we build that confidence. Creativity and decision making. Every time that we enter into the artistic process, we are learning about how to be creative thinkers in all aspects of our lives and how to make a decision. Perseverance. Those times when you come across something that just doesn't work out for you the first time, learning how to find a new way to see a problem, a new way to kind of attack these things in our lives. We learn perseverance, collaboration, constantly learning how to be the person in charge and be the person following somebody else's lead, working together to become better. Accountability. Our students have a certain amount of, they have to answer. We are a regional arts school and we need to produce and we need to improve and we need to get better. And ultimately, it gives our students a way to express themselves when a regular system without this level of arts, sometimes our students are left without a voice in the world, and we give them a voice. And it's through that performance, it's through our art subject councils within the school, just a fantastic way to express themselves. And focus. Sometimes just having that model of what to do next. I know that this is coming next, and so I have to prepare. And it's that whole learning cycle that will stay with them throughout their life, long past St. Roch.
Yeah, Mr. Marr, and I would just add to your points there that the students in the arts program are really leaders in our school. They're leaders in other facets too, whether it be sports or different clubs, student council, presentations like our Black History Month. And they're the ones that we see as leaders in front of our community. And then ultimately, especially talking to them in once they've graduated, they become leaders in their post-secondary institutions also.
Absolutely.
So what are we looking for, Mr. Marr?
Well, the first thing that we really want more than anything, and a lot of people think, oh, we want students that are incredible performers. It's not actually that. Although we like that, what we're looking for are people who are committed, being committed to the learning that we're doing, being committed to the process, the four-year process of becoming a stronger human being. We are looking for people that are passionate about the arts. passion will take you a long, long way. We want people to get involved, involved in the community of Brampton, of St. Roch, of each arts area. It's that involvement that brings forth so many advantages. And people who have a demonstrated desire to learn, people who can show that they are here to take in the skills that we're offering and to incorporate them and make themselves better at what they do.
So what does that word commitment mean? Well, we are. You want to jump in here, don't you?
Well, commitment's always one that's a tricky one. And what does it mean to be committed? And years ago, I was practicing this same speech at home. And my daughter at the time was 3-4 years old. And she said, "Dad, what's that word, commitment?" That's the hard part. How do you explain commitment to somebody who hasn't experienced it before? And so I was kind of, and so I went into teacher mode and I said, "Well, what do you think commitment means?" And she said very innocently, "Well, it sounds like you say you're going to do something and then you do it." And really, that's what it is. We want people to make a commitment because it's not going to be easy every time something challenging comes up. It can't be, "Oh, well, I tried." We are looking for people that are willing to persevere through that and honor a commitment for their entire time here.
And excellent preparation for their next step, where there will be all kinds of challenges and obstacles, and they will have to persevere through them. So it really is a great preparation for post-secondary or whatever they're going to do. So we are asking for a 5-year commitment, and you're going to say, "Well," and this is actually Mr. Marr's idea, "Wait a minute, high school is only 4 years." However, the process actually starts in grade 8, and where you begin the process of committing to a program like St. Roch's Regional Arts Program. So here you are on the open house on November the 18th, and then you're going to need time to complete your application. There are obviously steps to complete it, and then you're going to submit it online by December the 9th at midnight. Once you submit that, we will contact you and let you know when your workshop is and then your audition. So once you've submitted the application, we'll then communicate with you by the email that you've indicated on your application. So you don't have to worry about anything because we'll contact you for the next steps. And then, of course, remain in the program for the full years of high school and participate in extracurricular activities. Every area has different types of extracurricular activities. They're unique to each area. So you're going to have to go to those breakout sessions and learn more about what is actually involved in those activities. So what do we mean by expertise? Mr. Marr, what do we mean by this?
Oh, this was one of my favorite readings and finds from years ago. It comes from a book by a man named Malcolm Gladwell. And he talks about practice makes perfect, the 10,000 hour rule. It takes 10,000 hours of deliberate practice to become an expert. And it comes from his book, The Outliers. Definitely a good read for anybody out there wanting to know a little bit more about what it takes to become an expert at something. With that 10,000 hours, a lot of people think about overnight successes. We hear like people like the Beatles or Bill Gates with Microsoft. You know, they dropped out of university. But we don't always stop to think, how did they become an expert at that? Because people don't just naturally become experts. It takes about 10,000 hours. It takes time devoted to learning the details of what you do. It takes time to get better and better and better. And this program is a lot about showing you the path to become an expert. And so the biggest thing that we are looking for are people who want to be experts. Now, there are a few steps to help you. I believe I put the word cheat on there, but to help you get through the 10,000 hours. One of the first steps is to get a coach. And by coming to the program, that's one thing you do. We have some of the most incredible instructors in our different arts areas with a world amount of experience in their area. And coming in here, somebody who's gone through the steps and the path can always help you get further down the path. Surround yourself with like-minded individuals. And that's really what an arts program is about, is to put you into a community with other people who think, feel, and act just like you. Building expert habits, whether that's through rehearsal, our class, the routines of experts. Sometimes we get caught up on the small stuff. And those coaches and like-minded individuals can help you realize when it's a small stuff thing and when it's, this is something we need to master.
Yeah, I was going to say, Mr. Marr, that one of the things that I find, you know, and you and I teach, you know, primarily vocal, mm-hmm. that because they have those like-minded individuals and they're working together, they're very driven. They're very motivated. And so it's not whether or not they're moving on to post-secondary or, you know, whatever the next step is for them, but it's what they're going to be doing because they're very driven and they help each other get there. So that feeling of family is really embedded into our program. And I love it. I love the fact that they're there to support each other throughout the 4 years.
Absolutely. That's always been one of my favorite parts of the program. When I hear them, that they get together and work outside of the classroom so that when they come in, you know, we can go to yet the next step. One of those things is deliberately practice. And I know with my own kids at home, one thing was always when it becomes homework time, how much of the homework time is being used deliberately? Do you find yourself saying, okay, I'm going to do my homework. I have to go get a pencil first. And then I got to go get a snack. And then I have to, oh, I forgot my textbook. I'll go get my textbook. And these things all pile up. And by the time you actually get to do some work, you do about 5 minutes of actual practice or homework. And you say, well, I've been at this for an hour. But it's not. It's that deliberate practice. And so we often put that word deliberate practice in there and deliberately trying to improve, coming up with a plan. And the arts are strong in that, in helping people come up with a deliberate plan on how to practice. And another kind of foundation block of the regional arts program is teaching others. We have courses where the students come together constantly, and we teach others something that we have become strong in. Our senior students help our junior students. Always teaching others gives you an even further understanding and mastery level that goes beyond just basic understanding.
And I like that, to get on your case.
Yeah.
I like doing that.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite jobs too, getting on their case to put them back on track.
Right, and sometimes they don't like you very much, but I think parents, and Mr. Marr and I are both parents. I'm a father of four, he's a father of two, that we want our students ultimately to be successful, and we are at St. Roch, we're about excellence. We're about getting our students to be the very best that they can be so that when they move on to their next step, or they're in another class, that they're also about the pursuit of excellence and then helping each other get there.
Yeah. And overall, what are we looking for in a regional arts student? And a lot of people get concerned because we do ask for a copy of report cards and for teacher comments. And some students kind of go, uh-oh. it's not a lot of the individual marks that we're looking at. The biggest thing that we look at are E's and G's. Where do we find E's and G's on the report card, Mr. McCallen?
Oh, those learning skills of the report card. And it's funny you should say that, Mr. Marr, because as a parent, I look at those. Responsibility, independent work, initiative, organization, collaboration, and self-regulation. These are so important. And we really do value the teachers in grades 7 and 8 who are the ones that are with these students day in and day out. And they're really saying to us, this is what, you know, this student is like each and every day. So sometimes as through this audition process, we only get a bit of a snapshot, but that report card and the teacher reference and the character references allow us to build who they are. So these report cards, this particular learning skill, and as you mentioned, Mr. Marr, is more important than the marks themselves, because this tells us what are you like as a student day in and day out.
Yeah. And one thing that I will point out, because both Mr. McCallen and I have taught grade 8, one thing that we will point out is that if any student is worried about those learning skills, oh, I want to apply, but the learning skills, I don't always do that well in. If you ask your grade 8 teacher, they will be more than happy to show you and tell you how to increase those learning skills. And if you do increase those learning skills, that shows us that you have a dedicated desire to learn. And if you do change those learning skills, the marks will follow.
Thank you. So what else do we offer here at St. Roch? Well, there's a variety of clubs, from yearbook to social justice to weight training. And these are clubs outside of the regional arts. So we also have, for example, in the regional arts, we have councils that you can be on so you can help your program grow. But within the school itself, there are tons of different clubs that you can see the list there. And there's so many more. And if you want to start a new club, you can do that. You just need a teacher to supervise. So lots of opportunities outside of the regional arts. And of course, there's sports. And traditionally, our regional arts students are active in the sports. I think back to, and his name escapes me, Mr. Marr. Oh, Kyle Gouveia, who was in the instrumental program, but also quarterback of the football team. And lovely bell. Beautiful, right in my ear. And he went on, I believe, to study, or he is studying medicine right now.
Yeah, he's at the end of med school right now.
Yeah, so, you know, one of those success stories, and we have lots of them, because we do want our students to be involved, not just in the arts, but also in throughout the community. We want them to be really stewards, you know, and as our faith teaches us, you know, we are servants of God. So we serve our community at St. Roch and the larger community too. And of course, in sports, you know, there's lots of our students involved. And it's pretty exciting to go out and watch them perform. I remember watching 2 weeks ago, the girls rugby 17. And there has to be at least 5 or 6 girls from our regional arts program. And it's just great to see them do something else other than the arts. So frequently asked questions. Can I try out for more than one area? No, unfortunately, you're going to have to choose one. But there is an opportunity within the application to select a second and third choice. So what ultimately may happen, and it's a dialogue with the student. Student auditions for one area, but the teachers see potential in another area. And so they may come to, let's say, Mr. Marr and myself and say, hey, you know what, we had a student audition, but they're really, really good in this area. And they indicated to us that they didn't put down vocal as the first choice because they didn't think they were good enough. And lo and behold, they are. So we may offer them an opportunity in another area. And so putting down a second and third choice is an important part of the process. And we ask that you think heavily on that, because we will definitely open that up if there is space in another area. Does this limit what options are available to me in high school? No, we actually believe, in addition to the regional arts courses and all the mandatory courses, that all the other opportunities that are available to you make high school really a unique and an adventurous place. I don't know if you have anything to add there, Mr. Marr.
Yeah, one thing that we don't often talk about is those steps after St. Roch. When applying to colleges and universities, one thing that all those extra courses does add into is they're all what are called M courses, which means they can be used on your university and college applications. And so our students are often very successful in their marks in those arts courses, and they help those averages when applying.
Will I still take all of the regular academic subjects? Yes, you do. There is no exemptions from any other regular academic subjects. So for every regional arts student, they are required to take all the mandatory subjects as outlined by the Ministry of Education. Should I apply? I love the arts, but I don't think I want to go into that career. Mr. Marr, do you want to take that one?
Yeah, we get that question a lot. You know, I don't want to choose regional arts because we don't want that as a career. The regional arts program has really paved the way for a lot of students that do want that as a career. We've had plenty of students that go on to college and university programs, into the workplace, performing professionally. We've had plenty of students do that. But I would say the majority of our students are looking at other plans. They want to study something else. But what this regional arts program has done has given them the confidence and the steps on how to become successful in whatever it is that they choose to do. So should I apply? I think everybody that has a passion for the arts should apply.
And I also liken this to sports, Mr. Marr. And I have a son, my youngest son, who plays AAA hockey. And he's in his midget year and he's thinking about playing beyond. But at the same time, he loves it. And he's just happy to be doing it. And it's something that gives him all those different skills of collaboration and a perseverance, which are the same in the arts, and allows him to develop those and really has enhanced the person who he is. So the arts do the same thing. It doesn't necessarily mean you're going to pursue the arts as a career, but all those skills associated will develop and allow you to pursue whatever area or career that you want to. So what is the application process? Well, number one, you have to get an application. And in a few minutes, Mr. Marr is going to show you on our website where everything is located and how to access that. But once you look up the application and you complete all the components, you're going to submit it to a Google form. There is a teacher reference in there, but we do not want you to send it to us. We're going to ask your teacher to directly send it to us. And there is a link there. And Mr. Marr, again, will show it to you later, where your teacher emails that. And then everything has to be submitted by December 9th. That being said, we're open for business tomorrow. So if you want to start submitting early, please feel free. It doesn't change anything. If you submit by December the 9th, it doesn't change where somebody submitted on November the 19th. We're just letting you know that we are open for business. You're going to attend the audition workshop in January. It's actually on January the 15th. And again, once you submit your application, we'll notify you what time your workshop is. They're a 1-hour workshop and you're with other students and we're just preparing you for the audition. And then following the workshop, as mentioned before, we'll give you your audition time. Specific information about auditions will be provided in your breakout session following our presentation here. And as mentioned, auditions will take place in late January. After the whole process is done, we will post acceptances. We post by a number. You will be given that number when you apply. So that's very, very important out of privacy for each individual, that your individual number. So for example, if you're a vocal major, it'll be VM for vocal major, VM2022-008 or 054. And that's what you're going to be looking for. And it's very, very important that you remember that number. Mr. Marr, do you have anything to add about that? Or do you want to go straight now to the website?
Let's go see the website.
Okay, good. So Mr. Marr now is going to show you where to find everything for the application and audition process. Take it away, Mr. Marr.
So here we have St. Roch Catholic Secondary School homepage, and you can get to that by going to www.dpcdsb.org and then the slash R-O-C-H-S. Once here, you can either scroll down and you'll see the Regional Arts Program is listed right there, or if you look under Guidance and Courses, there's the Regional Arts Program. Clicking on the Regional Arts Program will bring you to our Regional Arts homepage. It announces our virtual open house. It has the breakout rooms for as soon as we're done this presentation. You can log into those breakout rooms and find out a little bit more about each subject area. Then the application process. So the best thing to do is to download the Everything You Need to Know document. So if you click on that, it will open up and you can, it's a link back to our website where you can download the application package. Once you've got it all complete, there's a link to a Google form. You can click on there and submit all your documents. Here are all of the things that we need you to submit. So if you want to look ahead, parts A, B, and C. Part A is just information about you. Part B is student questions. And part C are some questions for the parents. A wallet size photo so that we start to build that community right away, seeing you as a face. A teacher referral, you can give that to your teacher. They'll fill it out and they'll send it directly to us just to avoid complications. So you don't have to actually submit the teacher referral. That will be done for you by the teacher. For all Peel District School students applying, many of your teachers might not be able to do the teacher referral, and so don't worry about that. A character reference letter, and then if you pay the fee for application online using School Cash Online, just take a copy of the receipt and submit that, as well as the grade 7 report card. If you do have an IEP, you can upload it there, and that just helps our ARD department figure out what supports will need to be in place. Further in December, we will have back on the main site some videos to help you with your auditions, examples, things like that. We also have the application form on here, the teacher reference form, a link to pay the fee. And then once you've got it all done, click on submit application and submit all your documents. There's a calendar there of the timelines for everything that we're going to be doing. And then further information on auditions will also be on there. And so now we're going to go back to Mr. McCallen.
Thank you, Mr. Marr, for providing information on our website and all important information the students need to apply to St. Roch. So the question is, why St. Roch then? After all this information has been presented, why should I go to St. Roch? Parents, why should you send your child to St. Roch? Well, first and foremost, we're a Catholic school. We're a faith-based environment. And God teaches us that everybody is created in his own image and everybody is treated with respect. We are an inclusive, diverse, and equitable environment. If you were to be in here, you would just see that everybody is welcome here of all abilities. And we think that the environment based on love and compassion is present each and every day. Family first. It's amazing walking into each different group, each different class, and each program, how inclusive and how students feel a real sense of belonging. When they come into the program, immediately when they're accepted, the older students come to them and make them feel welcome. And St. Roch is not a big program. You know, it's a small program, but its smallness is its uniqueness. And we really believe that feeling of family is present throughout their 4 years. Yeah. Success for all. Jump in there.
Feeling safe is a big part of high school. A lot of people come into high school fearing because they don't know what it's like. And having this sense of family, it really changes the high school experience and allows people to kind of explore the different things that the school offers.
Thank you, Mr. Marr. Success for all. It doesn't matter what you come in with. Our job here at St. Roch is to make your son or daughter successful, to provide them with the unique opportunities to grow, the skill set, like-minded individuals to make your son or daughter successful and ready for their next step. And from every indication from all of our students and our parents, we believe this is a really great place, kind of a hidden secret. But we believe that all of our students, you know, ultimately are successful and ready for whatever comes next for them. So that concludes our presentation, our main presentation. I'd like to thank you, Mr. Marr, for joining me. This was your first creation, and it's nice to combine with you and get all of your unique ideas. So the breakout sessions will start at 7 o'clock. So we invite you now to go get a drink, get what you need, have relax for a second, and then check out the links for each area and then join those and then get all the answers and information you need to make the right decision for your son or daughter. You'll see the list of teachers in drama. We have Ms. Zada Todd in dance, Ms. Conda Curry and Ms. Malazzi in instrumental, Mr. Haynes and Mr. Lamorte in media, Mr. Antonetti and Ms. Machino in vocal, yours truly, Mr. McCallen and Mr. Marr. And as mentioned before, Mr. Marr is the department head of the regional arts of the arts program. I am the regional arts coordinator. Of course, you can see I'm under Mr. Marr, that I didn't put myself first. He's the head chief. And then guidance.
Follow alphabetical.
And then guidance, Ms. Tomalilo, who is really a great support for our program. And then if you have any specific questions about, you know, courses throughout the 4 years, if we can't answer them, then Ms. Tomalilo can. So on behalf of Mr. Marr and myself, we hope you enjoyed your session and good luck in your breakout sessions. Have a great night, everybody.
Bye-bye.